The first conversation I ever had about the foundation was in the spring of 2013, actually. I was cooking up some fajitas, and I normally do some thinking when I'm cooking. I called my brother Patrick, who was on the school board at the time, and said, "Hey, I've got this really good idea. I think we need to start an education foundation." And he said, "That is a good idea, but it's already been had." And he was telling me about Karen Lively 5 years before, having gone to the school district and started talking about a foundation. So really the inception of the idea of a foundation in Whitehouse, to my understanding, goes back to Karen Lively.
The purpose of the foundation, the Whitehouse ISD Education Foundation, was to help the teachers with their creative ideas, have more support with carrying out their ideas, with finances that they didn't have in their own pockets.
There are so many opportunities that teachers could pursue if they had the budget, right? And school districts are allotted a certain amount that they can work with, and the tax base can only support so much, but that's never going to keep up with the innovation and creativity that the teachers themselves have. And this is an opportunity for the community to come together and fill those gaps.
I think any of us really understood at the beginning how much work it was going to be, but we had a passion to see some lives change in the school district, and really to see, more than anything, direct funds going into the class.
Well, I remember when we brought the consultants in and they were helping us develop the foundation and giving us the guidelines and the framework and how to go about it, which they were very helpful. And I do remember that, you know, they indicated that, you know, if you do 50,000 in your first couple of years or so, that's going to be tremendous success. And I think the first year we surpassed in 1 year what they may have expected us to do in 5 years.
It was all just, it was learning, but it was something I wanted to be involved in just simply because of what it was going to do for the district, what it was going to do for the community, or what I believed it was going to do. And that was kind of where it started for me.
Really interesting seeing the teachers that participated with us and sent in grants, mind-blowing, lots of tears, reading some of their... Sorry, I get speechless thinking about it, but seeing their dreams on paper.
The first prize patrol that we did, and I know Karen and I were both involved in that, that was pretty exciting.
And when you see the joy in the eyes of the students and the excitement in the teachers' eyes for that their ideas are going to come to life, I mean, that is a game changer.
Yes.
I think that's a great way to describe it.
You knock on their door and they come out and they just start crying. They're overjoyed with, you know, getting to spend this money and getting to share this with their students and know that it's going to help one student somewhere in their classroom, that this is going to make a difference in that student's life. So I think that's the biggest thing is knowing how joyful the teachers are, and they'll spread that joy to the students.
If I wasn't fully on board before, once you've been involved in the prize patrol and just the excitement and seeing the way teachers, the excitement of the teachers, the students, that was when it was a game changer for me.
I will never forget when, do you remember in that meeting when Jennifer was like, I'm trying to think if it would have been the second year or the third year, but she said she was going to be the head of the development committee, and all of a sudden she wanted to raise $100,000.
Yeah.
And we were all just like,
we're like,
okay.
That's a sight to be seen. I mean, Jennifer is perfect for that. So when you think about things that experiences, hey, that was a great experience seeing Jennifer Eccles, because she can go raise some money now.
She can. I loved to help raise money for them. I wanted every day. I made a cold call every single day. I may be on my way to work, on lunch, but that was something that I did. I just shared the passion.
He looked at her and he said, I hope you're not here for money or something like this. And she was like,
I do not remember all the details to the story, but he was not real pleased to see us there.
She did not waver, started visiting with him about, you know, the district and what we were doing and the foundation and what we were there for. And he turned around and started talking about how unpleased he was with some decisions the district had made. And about 5 minutes later, we walked out with a commitment and I think a pretty big check.
I think it was a $500 check. If I remember.
Yes, this man wanted us to leave from the get-go. And the day went like that. We would walk in businesses in Whitehouse, yeah. And none of the rest dreaded, but walked in, you know, I'm feeling a little uncomfortable that we're fixing to hit these people up for money, and walked out with money all day long, up and down Whitehouse. I mean, if there was a business, we walked in it. And that was a moment where I was just like super impressed with the people of Whitehouse, the businesses in Whitehouse, and their willingness when they heard what we were, you know, what the foundation was doing, and willing to be a part of it.
I don't think we could have ever envisioned that this is where we'd be just 5 short years later.
I think I'm proud to be a Wildcat. I think I love this town.
From the foundation as well as from the board, we would just like to give a huge thank you and shout out to the community for their involvement, for their support, and for their participation. And know that we're not at the finish line, we're just getting started. We need you to continue, but we thank you for everything that you've done to help us get us to where we are today.